business. It's owned by Knut and his wife Helena, and they have 5 children together, and they are all helping here with the everyday work. So outside in the stables, we breed Icelandic horses and also train them. And then here in the greenhouse as well, as you see, we grow tomatoes all year round. Now, many people find it strange that we can grow these tomatoes also in the winter time, knowing how winters are in Iceland. But then, of course, we do get a lot of help from nature, so it's not that difficult. So we have hot water in the ground in this area, and we also have a hot spring, which is like 200 meters away from here. So the water is almost boiling when it enters the greenhouse, and it's coming in all of these big white pipes you see all over the walls here, and also under and above the plants. The water is almost 90 degrees Celsius, so the pipes are also really hot, and then the constant temperature inside the greenhouse has to be always in between 23 and 25 degrees Celsius. And then to water the plants, we can use the same cold water as we all drink in our homes here. And that is really nice for us because the tomatoes are more than 90% made out of water. So then the better water we give them, the better tomatoes we get at the end. So that is really nice. And then as for sunlight, most of the time we have to use lamps. As you see, we have some lamps here in the greenhouses, and we have to have them on 17 hours a day in the winter and a little bit less now in the summer. And they are also switched off now because we have enough light outside. The energy we use for these lamps is all green, which is also really nice because the amount we are using would be enough to power a town of 7,000 citizens, so it is quite a lot. But all the energy we use is made from the steam of the hot water and then the cold water from the rivers. They are just powering turbines, and that's how we get the energy that we use in here. And then for the tomatoes, so let's speak about that a little bit. So we grow them from seeds here, and everything starts up in our nursery here. We call it a baby house. Currently it is empty. We planted out all the baby plants from here, but this is where everything starts. We plant the seeds in tiny sponge boxes over here, and then when they are 6 weeks old, we can start to plant them out in the big greenhouses here. And when we plant them out, we do plant them in bags of soil, so their roots, they can grow into the soil and absorb all the nutrients from the water that way. And one of these plants, they can live for 9 months here. They could even live longer, but after that they produce smaller tomatoes, so it's not worth for us to keep. But we keep them for 9 months, and by that time they actually measure 9 meters long, so then it's really huge. They grow around 1 meter per week, so then you have to lower them every time. So then you see these white ropes, that's how they are hung up. And then every week we have to lower them and we twist them around the ropes so they can grow upwards again. And then we also have to take some leaves from the bottom part here. That's why they look a little bit more naked. So that's because they focus more to produce the tomatoes than on feeding the leaves even more. And you see that the tomatoes always get red from the bottom, and that's really convenient for us that the heat comes from the bottom, of course. And also for the picking, we do pick these tomatoes here every morning by hand. And then we just use these pipes here as lanes. So we put some trolleys on it, and then we can sit and just pick the tomatoes like that and put it in a box next to us. So it is really nice. And we pick around 2 tons of tomatoes every year. So it is quite every day. I'm so sorry. 2 tons every day. So it is quite a lot. And then we also pack them here manually. And yeah, we do not export our tomatoes. We only sell them here in Iceland. That is because we like to pick them when they are the most red and the most flavorful. So we never pick them green to export it. So we just only sell it here. But then of course we also make products out of them. We do have some tomato jams and chutneys. I will also take you to our little tomato shop to show you. And those products we ship worldwide, so you can order it from anywhere. And yeah, I think this is about the tomatoes. Also we grow 4 types of them. We have the regular tomatoes that we use for most of our food and also for our tomato soup here. And then we have these cherry piccolo tomatoes, and we also have them in yellow version. Like these ones are yellow here. They are called Svidor, and they're actually a lot sweeter than the red ones. And we also have plum tomatoes and heirloom tomatoes too. They're also known as buffalo tomatoes. They're like these big chunky traditional looking tomatoes. And we do have them in red, yellow and purple. So it is a lot of colors. So we also use CO2 here, which is good for the plants. They need it for the photosynthesis process. So all the CO2 is coming in the black pipes here. There you see on the walls. And the CO2 level here is 3 times higher than outside. But then the balance is the same with the oxygen, so no one should get sleepy in here or anything like that. We do have our own tank of CO2, so that we can just push it from there to the plants. Now, in our other greenhouses, we do have really big fans to distribute it. In this house, we don't do it like that because of the restaurant. It would be really loud for the people. So then we just have this this in the back, black pipes. So then I will take you a little bit around to show how it looks. As you see, my colleague are also currently working on the plants, just lowering them down and twisting around the ropes. This here is also part of the restaurant that we are using on the weekends when it gets really busy. And you see here, in also in the baby house, we do grow some sunflowers and some cucumbers as well. And the sunflowers, of course, are just mostly for decoration. We do not use them for anything else. But we also have some basil here that we also have on every table, and you're welcome to use it for the food. So that is not just decoration. We also have some salad trees in the back. We are growing some salads and also just nice colorful flowers also for decoration and also for our bumblebees, so they have variety. And I will tell you about our bumblebees as well. So here we have our tomato soup buffet. So the soup is for self-service at our place. And you can refill your plate as many times as you'd like. The bread is home baked here every morning in the kitchen. It is really nice and tasty, and also the soup is nice and fresh. It's made from our tomatoes. And then of course we have different kinds of bread with cheese on top or with seeds. Also with cheese and olives, that is actually our most popular bread here. Everyone seems to really like it. And to pollinate the tomato flowers, we use bumblebees here. We actually have to import them from the Netherlands. And then they come in boxes like these. Now each box contains one queen, and she's the one over there. I'm not sure if you can see it through the phone. She's this really, really big one, almost twice the size of the rest. And then 60 female workers are in the box with her. And we have approximately 1,200 bees flying around here and doing their jobs. And they just help us to pollinate the flowers. And we actually have to exchange the box every 3 weeks or so, because they just die out, unfortunately. They don't live that long. And the queen lays eggs, of course, later on, but then the new generation is mostly male bumblebees, and they don't really pollinate any flowers for us. So it's mostly the females that do this work. The male's job is to find the new queen, but then that's not really efficient for us, so then we always have to change the box, so then we get the new female bees to work here. And also for pesticides, we don't use any pesticides or any chemicals. So if we have box here, then we just use biological pest control. We have a system that we call good flies against bad flies. Actually, the good flies are also coming from the Netherlands here. They're called Macrolophus. They are tiny green flies, and then they just eat off the eggs of the bad flies from the leaves of our plants. And it's very simple like that, our problem is solved. And yes, let me show you our little tomato shop here, where you can find our products that we also ship worldwide. So this is the entrance where you come into the restaurant, and then the first thing you see is our tomato shop here. And of course you can buy our fresh tomatoes, some salad and also cucumbers that we grow here. But then we also have the products that we can make out of these tomatoes. So we have some tomato jams here. We also have green one and red one. The green one we also use for our cheesecake that we have here as a dessert. And then we also have some salty things, of course, barbecue sauces. Now that it's summertime, that's getting really popular. But then of course, then cucumber salsa, which is like pickled cucumbers. It is really nice for our home-baked bread here. Then we also have the base of our Bloody Mary. So this is the red drink, then we also have it in a green version, and some tomato chutney, but of course also some spices and our tomato soup, which we also ship. So if you're not able to come here, then you can always just order it online. It comes in a nice jar like that, and then you just heat it up and it's almost the same. We also have some spices here. So yes, and these things you can all find in our online shop. So on our menu we have of course our famous tomato soup with the home-baked bread. So it is on a buffet style for self-service. On the tables you always find some butters. It's Icelandic butter, really nice. Some sour cream for the soup and cucumber salsa for the bread also. And you're more than welcome to use the basil plant that we have on each table and just cut the fresh leaves in your soup or in any other food if you'd like it. It's really nice. We do have some soup sticks. So if you don't want just plain tomato soup, you can always order it with chicken, cheese, vegetable or seafood as well. And I do recommend the seafood one if you like seafood in general. But then we also have salad. It's a mixed salad with most of the things that we are growing here for ourselves. And we also recommend to get that with a stick, and you can make it into a seafood salad or chicken salad. It is really nice and fresh. We do have some tortilla as well. That's like a pizza margarita. It's stone baked, comes with tomato sauce, different kinds of cheeses, and also has tomatoes on top. We also have pasta. Our pasta is ravioli. There's spinach and ricotta cheese inside for the filling, and then it comes with our homemade tomato sauce and pesto. Then we do have heirloom tomatoes with our burrata cheese. The heirloom tomatoes, of course, we grow here, and this burrata cheese, it is Italian style, but it is Icelandic cheese. It is like a huge mozzarella cheese. It has this creamy inside. It is really nice. It's also recommend to share it. If you're coming, then you can just share it on a table for everyone to taste. And then we also have mussels. The mussels are local mussels. They are coming from the Westfjords. And then we prepare it in like a seafood tomato sauce. So it is also really good, and our bread goes with all the foods that we have on our menu, not only with the tomato soup too. So you can just take home baked bread with anything. And as desserts, of course, we also have some tomato-y desserts. We have tomato ice cream, and then we have tomato cheesecake. We also have green tomato and apple pie, and then tomato sorbet. So we do have different kinds of desserts as well. Of course, all of them with tomatoes, but they're really nice, so do not worry about the tomatoes. And as for drinks, of course, you get the very clean Icelandic water on every table. But then we also have a drink menu. So we have our tomato beer here, which is brewed in Reykjavik only for us. And we do have different kinds of it. We do have a red one from the red tomatoes, which is more like a lighter summer beer. And then we also have a darker one, which is more like a pale ale made from our green tomatoes here. Then as for cocktails, of course, we have Bloody Mary. Then we also have the virgin version without alcohol. And then we have Happy Mary, which is almost the same thing. It's made from the green tomatoes. It's a green tomato drink base, and then it's made prepared with gin instead of vodka. Then we also have a non-alcoholic version called Healthy Mary. And we also have Mary Poppins, which is more like a cucumber-based drink. It's a cucumber mint and lime sorbet. And then we add some popping candy in it, so that's why it's called Mary Poppins. And then we also have the alcoholic version with sparkling wine and without alcohol, with just sparkling water. And of course, regular drinks as well, without any tomatoes. We have different kinds of sodas and coffee drinks and wines, so not everything is with tomatoes. And yeah, I think it's good.